Hello class, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. So students, welcome once again to your maths class. I, Achal Singh, welcoming you all once again to your maths class. So class, in the previous session, as you all know that we were on exercise 10.1 in which we were doing the addition of the units of measurement. Okay? So now we will begin. So up to question number 6 we had already done in the previous session. So now I'm going to start with the question number 7, that is subtract or subtraction. So first of all, the topic I'll write here, that is chapter number 10, that is measurement. Of weight, exercise 10.1. Okay, chale. Now let's begin with the topic. Okay, so now in question number 7 we need to subtract. Okay, so now we are going to subtract. Okay, so subtract the A1 kg and grams. So we need to subtract it. So two units, standard units of measurement is kilogram and gram, and 80 kg 907 gram minus 67 kg 985 grams. Okay, so 80 kg 907 grams minus 67 kg, this is the A part of question number 7, 67 kg 985 grams. So let's do it. 7 minus 5 2, 0 minus 8. So is it possible to subtract 8 from 0? No. So this 0 will borrow from here, so this will become 8, it will become 10. 10 minus 8, 2, 8 minus 9, not possible. So it will borrow from here. But ye bhi already 0, so that ultimately they are going to borrow from here. So it will become 7. This will become 10. But when it will end 1 to this, it will become 9 and it will become 18. So now 18 minus 9, 9. 9 minus 7. That is 2, 7 minus 6, 1. So the answer is, after subtracting it, we got the answer, that is 12 kg 922 grams. So the answer is 12 kg 922 grams. So this is the answer for the A part of question number 7. Moving next to the B part. Okay, so in B part, let's subtract. Okay, again the two standard units of measurement, kilograms and the grams. So 93 kg 760 grams, 93 kg 760 grams minus 89 kg 959 gram. Okay, so let's subtract 0 minus 9, not possible, so 0 will borrow from here. This will become 5, this will become 10. So 10 minus 9, 1. Now this is 5, this is also 5. So we can subtract 5 for prime. Yes, so 5 minus 5, 0. 7 minus 9, not possible, so borrow from here. This will become 2. This will become 17. 17 minus 9, 8. This is 2. 2 minus 9, not possible, so 2 will borrow from here. This will become 8 and this will become 12.
12 minus 9, 3, 8 minus 8, 0. So after subtraction, we got the answer, that is 3 kg 801 grams. So the answer is 3 kg 801 grams. Okay, so this is a simple subtraction as you have done earlier. Okay, so this is just similar to that. Okay, and this is the solution for the A and the B part of question number 7. Okay, you can pause it here and note it down in your notebooks. Chale. Moving next to the question. Okay, so now the next is the C part, that is also of subtraction, a simple subtraction that you will do by yourself. Okay, so let's move to the question number 8. Let's move to the next question, that is question number 8. The question number 8 is subtract 12 kg to 325 grams from 28 kg 760 grams. Okay, so this is the A part. 12 kg 325 gram from 28 kg 760 grams. So we need to subtract this from this. So we need to subtract 12 kg 325 grams from 28 kg 760 gram. So first of all, we are going to write it in the tabular form. So let's write it in the tabular form. Okay, so isko isse karna hai, to ye upar aayega. That is kilograms and the grams, the two standard units. So 28 kg 760 grams minus 12 kg 325 grams. So let's subtract. So this is 0 minus 5. So 0 will borrow from here. It will become 5. This will become 10. 10 minus 5, 5. 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. 7 minus 3, 7 minus 3, 4, 8 minus 2, 6, and 2 minus 1 is 1. So after subtraction, we got the answer, that is 16 kg, 435 grams. So write down the answer, that is 16 kg, 435 grams. So this is the solution for the A part of question number 8. You can pause it here and note it down in your notebooks. This is a simple subtraction. So rest of the B, C and the D part, they are also similar to it, but there's a little change, the C and the D part in the gram unit. So I'm going to explain it here and later on you can do it by yourself. So let's move to the D part and rest of the part B and the D, sorry, B and the C, that you will do by yourself. So let's do the D part. Okay, so I'm explaining the D part. B and the C part you will do by yourself. Sorry. Moving to the D part. So in the D part we need to subtract 17 kg 525 gram. 17 kg 525 gram from 30 kg 8 gram. From 30 kg 8 grams. Okay, so we need to subtract this from this. So let's subtract. This is kilogram. This is gram. Okay, this is 30 kg 8 gram. 30 kg 8 gram. Next is subtract 17 kg 525 gram. Now this is 8,
it's a single digit whereas here we are in three digits. So how we are going to write in three digits? So dekhiye, if we write this 8, okay, maine kal bhi bataya tha, if we write 8 as like this, if we increase two zeros at the back, it will become 800 grams. But in the question, it is 8 grams. So in that case, we are going to write it as 008 grams. So it will remain as 8 grams. Okay, so write down the two zeros before 8. That is 008. So it is now the 8 gram. Agar aap iske peeche 0 badhayenge, it will become 800 gram and that is not our requirement or the question. Right? Chali. So let's subtract and find the answer. 8 minus 5, 3. 0 minus 2, 0 minus 5, 0 minus 7. So brought it from here, that is 2. Okay, this is 9. 9 and this is 10. 10 minus 2, 8. 9 minus 5, 4. 9 minus 7, 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So the answer is 12 kg 483 grams. So the answer is 12 kg 483 grams. Okay, so this is the solution for the D part of question number 8. Okay, so you can pause it here and note it down in your notebooks. This is the D part of question number 8. Chalo. Moving next to the question number 9. So rest of the parts of question number 8 you will do by yourself in your notebooks. Question number 9. A container can hold 50 kg sugar. It has only 30 kg sugar, 500 gram sugar. How much more sugar can be put into it? Okay, so there's a container. Okay, so there is the already 50 kg sugar is inside it. Okay, and sorry, they have given a container can hold 50 kg sugar. So a container can the like container hai, box hai. So in the container means in this object in which you can keep something. Okay, so there's a container that is having 50 kg. But 30 kg 500 gram sugar is already into it. Okay, उसके अंदर पहले से ही 30 kg 500 gram sugar है. So how much more sugar can be put into it? उसके अंदर और कितनी sugar रखी जा सकती है? Okay, so capacity of the container is 50 kg and the sugar in the container is 30 kg 500 grams. Now how much more sugar can be put into it? Okay. So that we need to calculate. So total capacity में से if we subtract the amount of sugar that is already in that container, so we can easily calculate the how much more sugar can be put into it, right? So let's do question number 9. So capacity of the container, capacity of the container that is 50 kg. Capacity of the container that is 50 kg. Okay, sugar in the container. Sugar in the container. Sugar in the container. That is, how much sugar is already in the container? That is 30 kg 500 grams. That is 30 kg 500 grams. So this is the sugar capacity that is already, this is the capacity of sugar that is already in this container. Now how much more sugar? Okay, more sugar can be put.
ओके सो दैट वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट और कितनी शुगर उसके अंदर रखी जा सकती है. इफ द कैपेसिटी इज 50 केजी एंड इट इज होल्डिंग ओनली 30 केजी 500 ग्राम सो दैट मीन्स मोर दिस मोस्ट कैपेसिटी सॉरी दे आर द मोर शुगर कैन बी पुट इन टू इट सो दैट वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट सो दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट बाय सब्ट्रैक्टिंग दी All the amount of sugar, the quantity of sugar that is already in the container from the total capacity of the container. Okay, so let's subtract kilograms and the grams. Okay, so let's subtract 50 kg and another is 30 kg, 500 grams. Okay, this is 50 kg and this is 30 kg 500 grams. In 50, we don't have any other measurement. Sorry, we don't have any number for in the grams. The kilo 50 is. So how you are going to solve it? So in such type of cases, what we do? We just increase the three zeros because zeros agar hum aage badha denge, okay. ओके दिस इज द ग्राम सो ग्राम में अगर क्वालिटी कुछ नहीं सो दैट मीन्स इट इज रिप्लेस विद जीरो ओके सो दिस इज जीरो सो वी अज्यूम इट एज जीरो तो अगर यहाँ पे के जी दिया है 50 देखिए राउंड फिगर इज गिवन सो इन ग्राम यू कैन पुट थ्री जीरोज फॉर द ग्राम्स ओके नाउ सब्ट्रैक्ट इट जीरो माइनस जीरो 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 माइनस जीरो जीरो Okay, just a minute. For some reason, I'm filling so that we can write the solution sentence. Okay, so again, I'm writing this is kilograms and the grams. This total capacity is 50 kg. And subtract 30 kg, 500 grams. So that it was right doing. So now subtract it and find the answer. This is 0, 0. 0 minus 5, not possible, it will borrow from here. But here also we are having 0, so it will ultimately borrow from here. This will become 4, this will become 10. Now when it lends from here, it will become 9 and this will become 10. So now we can subtract it, yes. So 10 minus 5, 5, now it is 9. 9 minus 0, 9. 4, 3. So 4 minus 3, 1. So what is the capacity or the how much more sugar can be put into it? So that is 19 kg and 500 grams more sugar can be put into it. Into the container. Okay. So question, what was the question? How much more sugar can be put into it? Therefore, 19 kg and 500 grams more sugar can be put into it. Okay, therefore, 19 kg and 500 grams therefore 19 kg 500 grams more sugar can be put into the container. Okay. So capacity of the container is equal to 50 kg, sugar in the container is 30 kg 500 gram. How much more sugar can be put into it? So for that we need to subtract the already the quantity of sugar that is in the container from the total capacity of the sugar. So it's total capacity of the container and we got 19 kg 500 grams. And this is the answer that 19 kg 500 gram more sugar can be put into the container. So this is the solution for the question number 9. You can pause it here and note it down in your notebooks. Chaliye. So with this we have completed question number 9. Now from question number 9 we are beginning with the word problems of the chapter number 10. Okay. Chaliye. So let's begin with the next question that is question number 10. So now I'm starting with the question number. That next question is question number 10. That we will begin. The time is over, so we will begin with the next session. So for today, I'm just ending the session here only. So I'll see you again very soon in our next session. So till then, everybody, have a great day.